It blends images that are well known with long-lost gems found in a National Archives warehouse and digitized for the first time. The visuals are mesmerizing, seen in color in a theater, the tracks of the giant NASA crawler transporter, used to carry the massive Saturn V rocket that launched the crew into space, fill the entire screen. We knew these large format holdings existed, but it took a lot of research to really understand what was there, said Rooney, who worked with Miller to bring the reels to the silver screen. The real discovery part was in the research that led us to a lot of new information about the content and the quality of the material. All told, the archives provided the film crew with 279 reels of 16, 35, 65, and 70mm film. The 65mm and 70mm were considered the luxury format of their time, used in cinema in the 1950s and 1960s. Only a part of the trove was used for the 1972 film Moonwalk 1. NASA probably didn't use the reels because of the difficulty of working with these large formats, and they probably lacked the equipment and the expertise, said Rooney. Is there any more footage? NASA used the large formats for filming ground operations at the Kennedy Space Center, and on the ship used to retrieve astronauts Neil Armstrong, Buzz Aldrin, and Michael Collins at the end of their historic mission. As the camera pans from the top to the bottom of the rocket, viewers get a sense of its sheer enormity, as the astronauts silently pull on their suits. In the firing room and at mission control in Houston, rows and rows of male engineers are seen in white shirts and dark ties, as opposed to the somewhat more gender-balanced teams at NASA and SpaceX today. The film's success lies in its seamless combination of the iconic and the rediscovered in a single, fluid narrative, occasionally seen on split screens. The only narration is from the period, viewers are guided by the voice of the late, great CBS anchorman Walter Cronkite and the radio exchanges between the astronauts and Houston, which have been resynchronized with the new images. Back at the National Archives, a team of 25 is working to finish digitizing the rediscovered film reels to make them public.